Assalamualaikum and very good morning. Now this is exercise in your postal textbook page 11. Okay, so it's about sports. Okay, now sports, there are many kinds of sports, but today we are going to look at urban sports. Okay? The title up there is urban sports. So urban means something in the city. So bandar lah. So urban sports means sukan yang you buat dalam bandar. Okay, as you can see in the picture, there are two kinds of sports here. Okay, the first one is called parkour. Pretty sure you know this one. It's like ninja jumping around, so it's called parkour. And second one we have skateboarding. All right, so we are going to read one magazine interview today. So magazine interview means temuramah majalah. Okay, so somebody will be interviewing another person. So if you can see here, there's a reporter here. Okay, so reporter means wartawan. Okay, so the job for reporter is to ask questions. Okay, so who is this reporter interviewing? Dia tengah interview siapa? Okay, this person named John. Okay, who is this John? Okay, look at here. 17-year-old John Harrison. Okay, his full name is John Harrison and he is 17 years old. Okay, so umur dia 17 tahun. Okay, so what is John going to do? He is going to tell us why urban sports are just what you're looking for. Okay, so why we should do urban sports, why we should join. Okay, look at the question, the first question that the reporter asked. Okay, first of all, what are urban sports? Okay, so dia nak tahu apa ni urban sports. Okay, so John says, urban sports are activities like skateboarding, BMX biking, scootering, and parkour. Okay, so skateboard, you know skateboard, BMX biking is basically basikal, scootering, scooter, okay, parkour is yang lompat-lompat tadi lah. Okay, and then he asked, who does them? Siapa yang buat these sports? So John says, teenagers. Okay, so teenagers means remaja. Okay, so teenagers and people in their 20s. Okay, so remaja and people in their 20s yang umur 20-an. Okay, so these people are interested in urban sports. Okay, most people who do urban sports want to have fun with their friends. So kebanyakan orang yang buat urban sports, they want to have fun with their friends, okay, and do something active. And then next question is, where do they practice? John says anywhere. You don't need any special facilities. Facilities means kemudahan. Okay, so you don't need, you can jump or skateboard over walls and cycle down steps. Every city has these things and they're free. Okay, so tempatnya kat mana nak buat ni? Tak kisah kat mana-mana. In the city, because city ada semua benda ni. Ada walls and ada steps. Means tangga lah. So boleh skateboard dekat mana-mana. Boleh lompat dekat mana-mana. No problem. Okay, and they are free. Okay, next. The reporter asks, do you need any special equipment? Okay, equipment pula. Tadi facilities. Facilities maksud dia tadi kemudahan. Now equipment. Equipment means kelengkapan. Like anything special that you need to wear. Right, so John says, depending on the sport, bergantung kepada sukan tu, you need a skateboard. Okay, sometimes you perlukan skateboard, a BMX bike or scooter and a helmet. Okay, parkour is the only urban sport that you can do without any equipment. So parkour sahaja yang tak perlu any equipment, tak perlu pakai apa-apa special. Okay, then the reporter asked pula, what do you wear? John says, we wear jeans or shorts, a t-shirt, and trainers. So basically, you wear like what you are comfortable with lah. Okay, and you say, so jeans, shorts, t-shirts. Okay, and trainers. Trainers dekat sini means shoes. Okay, so British English calls shoes as trainers. Sama maksud dengan shoes. Okay, then the reporter asks, Urban sports dangerous? Bahaya ke tak benda ni? And John says that depends. Sama juga bergantung. Accidents happen when people try to do dangerous things. If you try to do it, then it will become dangerous, okay? Kalau you buat tak berhati-hati. It's important to know what you can and can't do. So kena tahu your limit. Okay, next. Are there urban sports competitions? Oh, ada pertandingan tak urban sports ni? Then John says, yes, there are. Ada. Okay, then last question. Do girls do urban sports? Okay, girls buat juga tak? John says, yes. Lots of girls are getting interested in them now. They are often as good as boys or better. Okay, so ramai yang buat, start buat. Okay, kadang-kadang sama bagusnya dengan boys and ataupun lagi bagus daripada boys. Okay, next. So, once you have read this one, okay, lepas dah baca semua, it's time to answer the questions. Okay, kita ada dua exercises to do. Exercise 2 and exercise 3 on the same page. Page 11 in your textbook, exercise 2 and 3. Okay, those who can do on your own, you can try and do on your own. Those who need my help, okay, just listen, okay? Okay, so exercise 2 says, are the sentences true or false? Correct the false sentences. Ceritanya, ayat-ayat yang dia bagi ni betul ke salah? Okay, true or false? So, jawapan dia, you can find it here. True or false, and if it's false, kalau salah, correct the false sentences. Kena betulkan yang salah tu. Okay, for example, look at the first one. 25-year-olds don't do urban sports. Okay, so orang-orang yang berumur 25 tahun don't do urban sports. Ya ke? Tadi kita baca, people in their 20s. Okay, so if you are 25 years old, you are in your 20s. Okay, 20-an lah. So that one is not true. Okay, false. False, 25 year olds buat juga. Dia bukan tak buat, dia buat juga. Okay, so you suruh you correct the false sentence. Kena betulkan. People in their 20s do urban sports. Okay, so people in their 20s, orang umur 20-an memang buat juga urban sports. Okay, number two. Tengok the sentence. You can do urban sports in any city. Boleh buat dekat bandar mana-mana je. So is that true or false? Okay, so from what we read just now, urban sports boleh buat kat mana-mana je. So the answer is true. Okay. So for the rest, number 3, 4, 5, and 6, teacher nak you tulis dalam buku latihan, your notebook. Okay, so just copy again number 1 sampai number 6 and write down the answer. Is it true or false? Kalau true, you just write down true. If it's false, betulkan. Okay, now that's it. Then, after you are done with exercise 2, we go to exercise 3. Exercise 3 says, read the interview again and answer the questions. Okay, so baca soalan, sorry, baca interview tu tadi and jawab soalan dekat bawah. For example, okay, dia tanya, how many urban sports does John mention? Berapa banyak urban sports yang John sebut? Okay, so here. Cakap activities like skateboarding, BMX, biking, scootering, and parkour. So ada how many just now? 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So the answer is 4. Okay. And then question number 2. Why do people do urban sports? Kenapa orang buat urban sports? Okay, check balik. Okay, so here. Most people who do urban sports want to have fun with their friends and do something active. So dia buat sports ni sebab dia nak have fun dengan kawan-kawan and buat something active. Okay, so the answer is, oops, sorry. The answer is they want to have fun with their friends and do something active. Okay. So these are examples of number one and number two. So sama juga in your notebook. Jawab semua soalan ni. Number one, two, number five. Okay. Write it in your notebook. And then send the pictures to me on Telegram. Okay. That is all. If you have any question, you can ask me on our Telegram group. Okay.